Hi, Pastor. Now, you're probably like, hey, don't start calling me Pastor. I'm just starting this video. I think in the church, we have a big misunderstanding on what it means to pastor people and who's actually called to pastor. You see, a lot of times we confuse church leadership for pastoral ministry. And to lead a church, yeah, you pastor a church, you shepherd a church. But really, everybody is called to pastor. Did you know this, that the word pastor is only mentioned 3 times in the whole New Testament? And 2 out of the 3 are talking about Jesus. The third we find in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 3. Let me read that to you. It says this: so Christ himself gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the pastors, and teachers. So that's the third time. He gave them essentially to the church to equip his people for the works of service so that the body of Christ may be built up until we all reach unity in faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God and become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. So here's what this is saying, that there are pastors, people who are gifted and called. And in verse 1, it says to live a life worthy of the calling you've received. So you've got a calling from God, and you're supposed to use that grace gift, calling gift, in order to equip the church. But if you don't have that grace gift, that calling gift, then you're actually supposed to be equipped in order to do that so that the church matures. And so actually everybody is called to pastoral ministry in some form or another. Now you may be pastoring a small group or pastoring your family. You may be shepherding, pastoring a whole church, but we're all actually called to have that skill set active, operating in our lives. Now, a lot of times we confuse pastoral ministry for church leadership, but in our church family, two of my favorite pastors are actually not on staff. These are folks who are wired to care for people, to love on people. One is a retired pilot, and he loves to love on people. He offers care and direction and nurture. He's showing up when people are having a hard time. Maybe they're having surgery. He's sitting with them. He's praying for them. He's loving on them. This guy lays down his life for people, and he really fulfills the role of a pastor, which is to walk with people so that they can spiritually mature and to care for people in hard times and see them move into health and into spiritual growth. Another one of my favorite pastors in our church family is a dentist. And she actually, her primary pastoral ministry is not even in the church. It's actually in the dentist office. And her patients come in and she's loving on them. She's caring for them. She's really, really being like Jesus, displaying the pastoral facet of who Jesus is to her patients. And she's seeing them encounter God's love, be cared for, be connected to the church. She's praying with them. And so I think if we can take the religious mindset off of pastoral ministry, we can recognize, one, that we're all actually called to pastoral ministry. Maybe you have a natural gifting, a natural bent towards pastoral ministry. Maybe you don't. Maybe you actually have a hard time liking people. But I believe this, that if we can be equipped in pastoral ministry, which we're called to be if we're in the church, then we can learn what it looks like to display that facet of Jesus to people in our lives. And so I want to encourage you to start to think about yourself differently. Recognize that you are actually called to love on people, to care for people, to shepherd them, to bring direction to them, no matter where you are in life. You may be a student in the classroom, you may be a teacher, you may be a mom or a dad or a big sister or a friend, but I believe that you actually have a call to pastor people, to walk with them in hard times, to help them mature, really to make disciples, help people grow. And so I'm really excited over these next sessions to dive in with you and help you recognize how called you really are to shepherd people, to care for people, to provide spiritual leadership in their lives. Thanks for joining us.